Hey guys, Chuke here with Chuke's Outdoor Adventures. Well, I've come up with the top six guns that you need to have for Alaska, and I feel like I'm a decent expert on this subject. I've been hunting for about 10 years now. I get bears every year. I've learned a lot from friends who are professional hunters and guides, but the most I've learned has been from my buddies from high school that have been hunting bears and moose for 20 plus years. So I'm just going to go down the list, that starting with the least important, which will be debated, down to the very most important gun you need for Alaska. So there's going to be a lot of debate about this, and that's fine. This is just my opinion. So starting with number six, the sixth most important gun you need for Alaska would be a standard 30-06 hunting rifle. Now this could be very contentious. The reason it's number six is because not everybody's going to hunt. A lot of people just love fishing or just living up here. But I think it's important to have. So I would say a Model 70 pre-1964 featherweight 30-06 would be the classic Alaska hunting rifle. Now a lot of people say that's too small for brown bear. Fish and Game says that it's, you don't need anything bigger. I tend to agree with them. With a good shot placement, you know, a 220 grain 30-06 bullet is going to be really devastating to any large game. I personally have a 300 Win Mag, which is, you know, slightly beefier than a 30-06 that I like. I'm also a big 270 person. You know, I've got it. If you can afford it, get a mountain rifle or something. This is chambered in 270. It may not be ideal for Alaska, but I find that I kill large game just as good, if not better, sometimes than my 30-06, which is surprising. So some people will disagree with me there, but a hunting rifle, 30-06, Model 70, Winchester, action is just smooth as butter. Get a classic Leopold scope on there. I know I've been anti-Leopold in the past, but I'm starting to go back to them. But that is number six of what you might need. A lot of my friends are buying Tikas now for a decent price, you know, $600 for a Tika mountain rifle style gun. So I would suggest that too, if you want to get a Tika in 30-06. But that's number six. Number four is a big bore, or sorry, number five is a big bore revolver, 44 Magnum at the least. If you have to go 357, you know, Michael Kaler has one, and that's all you have, that, you know, that's better than a sharpened stick. That one, at one point in time, all I had was a 357 Magnum, and that will work, but you want 44 or bigger, preferably. I've got a 454 Toklat here. It is safe. Revolver is just really reliable. It makes you feel very confident in bear country, whether you're fishing or hunting. Have this as a backup weapon. A lot of people like the chest holsters. I like the chest holsters. There's nothing wrong with a hip holster. One of the main reasons they like the chest holsters, guides and stuff, is because you can, it's right there. You can just grab it. If you're falling backwards, it's easier to get it than a hip holster. But if all you have is a hip holster, that's fine. When you're in thick brush, you should have a weapon out anyways. So that's number five, big bore revolver. 44 Magnum, Smith & Wesson, or Ruger is what I prefer. I'd say get a Ruger Alaskan in 44 Magnum. Number four is the 45-70 lever gun. I prefer Marlins. Hammerheart and myself both went to his cabin last weekend, and we both had Marlin 45-70s ready because bears had ripped up his insulation underneath his cabin. And when we first got there, you know, we were both on edge with our 45-70s out. Even though we had pistols, we had these things. This is what guides use. You know, it's referred to as a guide gun. Nice short barrel, just a hard hitting round. So 45-70 lever gun is number four. If you don't have a pistol, bring that with you with the family when you're fishing or picking berries. It will stop a bear. So that's number four. Number three, this is highly debatable too, is a 10 millimeter pistol. I prefer Glocks, and out of the Glocks, this is safe. I prefer the Glock 20. You know, I've got other videos on here. It's the debate that never ends. Plenty of people up here are killing brown bears with 10 millimeters. It's a thing. And as always, the chest holster. I prefer the GS holsters, Kydex chest holster. So I probably take this more than any of my guns out with me. So you could even put this at the top if you wanted to, but I call it number three. So 10 millimeter pistol, you know, if you want a SIG P220 in 10 millimeter or double stack 1911, it's your choice. I just prefer Glocks, but I really like 10 millimeter because of the high capacity and the damaging round it does, you know, semi-auto to take down a bear. So that can be argued, but that's what I choose as number three. Number two may be a surprise to you, but it's a 9mm carry gun. This is my actual carry gun right now. It's a Glock 43, 10 plus 1, 9mm. In the summertime, I use extreme penetrators because I might see a bear. In the wintertime, I use HST with maybe an extreme penetrator in there. And the reason is because the crime has gotten so bad, especially here in Anchorage. Crime is horrible. There's crimes every day, violent crimes. You need to be able to protect yourself. I will say that when you're out hiking or fishing out in the middle of nowhere, it's good to have one concealed on you. Alaska gun laws are great. You don't need a license to conceal a gun because you may meet some long-haired guy with a huge beard that looks like Moses. More than likely than not, it's just going to be a super nice hippie that's going to be helpful to you, that, you know, he loves fishing salmon and eating moose meat. That's most likely what it's going to be, but I have run into complete paranoid whack jobs. You know, I'm the libertarian Alaskan type that loves freedom, but a lot of people move up here to Alaska to get away from people, and then they turn into just complete paranoid nut jobs. And there are those people out there. It's a thing. They're those people, very antisocial, very anti-people, living out in Alaska. They look like Moses, but they will hurt you and your family, possibly. They're very dangerous, complete whack jobs that live here in Alaska. You got to protect your family when you're out in the woods. So 9mm carry gun, something small that you can conceal well. That's number two, unfortunately, on the list. So what is my number one gun for Alaska? This may surprise you, and people may scoff at me, but it's a .22 rifle. Now, Chuck from Alaska Ballistics gave this to me. It's the Plinkster. I prefer a Ruger 10-22. If you want a bolt gun, it's just fine. But as a survival gun, you cannot beat a .22. In 2008, when we had the dry ammo around here, you could not find .22. People were in line waiting for 9mm and .22 whenever it came into the stores, and it would sell out within minutes. It's a great survival rifle. People have even killed polar bears with .22. Believe it or not, it's all about shot placement. You're not going to kill a charging polar bear, obviously. Well, you could kill it, but it's still going to kill you. But anyways, for small game, it's wonderful. Trappers use them. It's very cheap ammo. You can buy buckets full of ammo and save up for the Bugaloo or whatever. And you just can't beat it because you can get a suppressor for it. When you're out caribou hunting, you can kill ptarmigan out in the mountains, top off your freezer with all kinds of small game. .22 rifle, a great survival gun. You could protect yourself with it if you have to, kill small game. You can even kill large game and just buy years worth of ammo for very cheap. So believe it or not, it's the .22 because of the survival aspect of it. Comes in handy for all kinds of stuff. So number one, if you're just going to get something, I'd get a .22 and also a 9mm and a bear protection. But that's my list. We're also, someday, me and Ivers and Felton are going to do a trip where we just have a bear gun and then some .22s, and we're going to live off the small game for a few days that we hunt out in the middle of nowhere. There's different people that do that. It would be a lot of fun. But let me know what you think of the top six and how you would do it differently. Let the debates begin. Thanks, guys. It's Chuke, your friend in the field. Chuke's outdoor adventure.